Hi friends, today we will discuss about how we can process flat files in MuleFor. We'll see. First we'll know about what is a flat file, how we can define the flat file. See, flat file, it's a fixed width text files with the hierarchies. Like here, if we can see, these are the here we have 10 rows of data, and here different columns are there. And if you want to read manually, see here RQH and followed by some number is there, 2018 9. This is nothing but date, and again we have some 10 digits are there. This is details related to account, and this is currency USD. See, like this way we can read manually. These files are usually will get from legacy systems and DB systems. So we have to process these flat files. See, what we have to do is, to process these flat files, we should have the flat file schema definition. Let me open this schema definition. See here, based on this schema definition, we can validate the given flat file data. See, this is the flat file data we will receive to our MuleFor. So then we'll process this data. See, here we have all the data available. Here we have date details and currency details, and other transaction related details. Here if you can see, this is RQH is request header, and batch transaction. Here BAT is nothing but batch transaction, and RQF is nothing but request footer. See, if we go to this schema definition, here we can find the details. This is a flat file, and this contains the structures. See, batch request and name, they have given batch request, and this batch request contain RQH and RCH, TDR, BCF and RQF. See, RQH is nothing but, these are the different segments we have. See, this RQH is nothing but request file header record. See, here we have the elements, these are the element details: currency, unique file identifier, creation date, record type. These are the elements. Like this way we have for other segments also, we have the elements. See, BCH header record and transaction details record. See, these are the elements, nothing but data which is available in the flat file. See, okay, like this way we have the last one, is last segment is nothing but footer record. See, if you observe here, RQF record type, and the type is string and length is 3, and RQF, if we observe, see here they have defined this RQF. See, RQF and followed by batch count and length is 4, and file transaction account and transaction amount, the length is 12, and type unique file identifier, the length is 10. See, like this way they have defined. If you want to add another data, means, see, let me copy this one, let me copy this line, and let me add, let me save this one, make it, actually this application is running, let me make a request so we can know. See, here we got the exception, like too many segment repetitions RQF while reading payload as flat file. See, we are trying to add this data into the flat file, and we are try to process this input data, but in the schema definition we didn't define this details, so it is not accepting to process. So for that, if you want to access this one, see, let me delete this one. We have to, as per the schema definition only, it will process the number of segments. Okay, so if you want to process another segment, if you want to add in the flat file and you want to validate against this schema definition, means in the schema definition we have to add. See here, ID RKF is there and the related values, nothing but elements are there, right? We have to provide those all details. Okay, let me go through the mule flow, so then we can know about the flow. See here, I have a hospital flat file. See, these two rows are nothing but the data of the custom patient details, and this is the schema flat file schema definition. And what I am doing is I have processing this flat file data against this definition, schema definition. So see here, what I have did is in the payload, the payload will come, and in the MIME type, what we have selected is see here, in the MIME type we have take the application flat file as the type of the input data, and here we have added the parameters for schema path we have taken, and the file is nothing but dot ffd file for validating the input file, validating the input flat file data against this schema definition. Okay, we have did this, and then we have transformation, did the transformation. So let me make a request once again. So save, okay, I didn't save, I think. Let me save, and actually it's automatically build, and let me make a request once again. Okay, I got the response. See what I have given is, see, this is the hospital flat file data. Okay, if you see, I have other details also. I have another subflow in the main flow, below the main flow. So this is the hospital data I have received. See, this is the input, and this is the output data I have. See, name and address and phone number, again admin. See, name, address, number, and admin. See here, see, this is the first line data is available in this section. See in this object, JSON object, we have the first line data. This flat file first row data is available. This is the data, and ZZ BNGL, the second flat file row data is shown as like this. Okay, this is fine, right? Okay, then let me go to the another scenario. That is one scenario, and what I have did is I have calling a subflow from the main flow. For that I have used the flow reference, and here I have taken the file read, and I have configured the connector. See this is the file, and where I have to read the location I have given here. And one more thing is, let me show the remaining details. That is where we have to read the data. We have defined those details. Here, see, from the file schema I have given, in the schema I have the flat file details. this is the schema and this is the customer flat file details. We just had discussed this one, right? This is the schema definition, flat file schema definition. And while reading the flat file, customer flat file data, see what I have to do is I have to provide the input as flat file. In the MIME type, I have select the flat file, and schema path I have given customer.ffd. In the schema folder, I have this file, so I have given that file location. And once it picks the flat file, against the schema definition, it will validate our input flat file data. And see here, what I have did is, one second, okay. See, I have defined the set metadata. See, this is the customer schema. See, flat file schema I have given, and in the sample we have given this data, this flat file data we have given, so that we can see the preview also if you want. Otherwise directly we can see the data how it is. See, let me see, this is the transformation we have did. After that we have the logger, and we are writing the JSON data into customer.json. okay, that customer.json is also available in the schemas. Let me delete this one. So let me make a request from the postman. See, actually if you make the request, see, I have deleted, right? Now I got the data. See, it is reading the data from the customer flat file. See, this USD, RQH, these all details, we can see those details. See, this BAD. One second, some process is going on. See, we can able to see the this data. Record type, BAT, sequence number and account number, these all details are available in the flat file, customer this file. See, this is the account number. Okay, so like this way we have the TDR, transaction related details, and BCF, BCH, header details, and again TDR and BCF, BCH, and RQF, RQH. See, here we have these many rows of data is available. So we have to form this is the complete JSON. up to this is the complete JSON. This is another JSON appended. So let me delete once again. Let me make a request once again, so it will read the data from the, okay. So this is the way we have to read a flat file from the file location, and we again will save the JSON data into another customer.json file by using the write component, file write component. Okay, the main thing is we have to just transfer. In the transformation section we have to take care. Here I have set the metadata, the nothing but schema definition I have given, and input also I have taken sample input, then I have see the data here. Actually it is run, yeah, see here we can able to see the data. Let me change the sample data, edit sample data here, okay, so that we can BAT research, right? SC let me change this one, ACMA. Let me change this to ACMA to ACAA. I have changed that one, ACAA. Okay, it is reflected. Okay, guys. Thank you.